We are also blessed to live on Lake St. Clair, which is literally the heart of the Great Lakes. That was, a resolution that I passed when I went to Congress. That was the very first thing I worked on, was having the entire United States Congress recognize that Lake St. Clair is the heart of the Great Lakes. Not just because of its shape. If you look at it on a map, it looks like the heart, right? But the heart is our vitality. It's our life. And so it does have that analogy as well, and how important it is that we take care of this magnificent resource that we are also blessed to have here.
This is not just a Macomb County thing. This is a tremendous regional asset. And in fact, it plays perfectly into what they talk about at the state level to try to drive, if you will, people to come to Michigan with the Pure Michigan brand. Well, this whole idea about make Macomb your home, there could be no more perfect fit to the Pure Michigan brand than Lake St. Clair and what we have here in Macomb County.
We need to make sure that people are making good decisions about that lake. And the sure way to do that is to let people experience the lake. You have to be out on it. You have to feel the wind. You have to see the sun reflecting off the water. You have to smell it, as Julie said, to really appreciate it. And when you experience it, I think you'll make better decisions about the lake. So that's why we hold this event. So people who make decisions relative to the lake get to experience it. We're thrilled to have you here today for our 9th annual Lake St. Clair Appreciation Day.
Mark Hackle, I look forward to this event every year with you in the chamber. Here we are again on a beautiful day, taking in one of your jewels in Macomb County, and I know you've got some stores and businesses that are coming here because of all the recreating we do on Lake St. Clair.
Bob, this is incredible how far we have come, and again, in a very short period of time, to get people to realize this quality of life asset we have right here in our backyard. It's not just a Harrison Township, Chesterfield, advantage. This is something that's of value to the entire region and to the state of Michigan. Right. Pure Michigan, we get it, but nothing could be more pure than when we talk about Macomb County and our assets that we have. Lake St. Clair, 31.5 miles of coastline out here on the busiest freshwater lake than anywhere else on the planet. I tell you, I think you start to realize the importance of it, not just because the community is starting to see it, but even the business sector. Talking about L.L. Bean, you know, what's happening over Partridge Creek. They're coming here not just because by happen chance, but they realize these are people that like the outdoors. They like recreation. And even in Chesterfield, they're talking about the Cabela's out there. Yep. It's the same thing. They're realizing, you know what, there are people that really like this quality of life thing that's going on, and they are starting to see the value added with an incredible lake like we have out here. So it's a great story for us to tell, but one that we're realizing the word is getting out because people are really starting to appreciate it more.
Well, you've really taken a lead on that, Mark, because we've always had the lake, but no one really pushed the lake as something as an asset for the area.
And it is, and it's an asset as we talk about. You know, you and I are looking at our communities and trying to figure out, okay, what is it about, you know, not only the economic opportunities and how do we drive that, but quality of life. People like to work, sure, but you know what? They love to have that free time with their families and do things. And boy, if you ever watch families out here during the summer months, it's incredible. I mean, they're out there boating, they're water skiing, they're fishing, and it's such a joy to see. And I've known it since I worked on the Sheriff's Department Marine Division boats.
Exactly.
But now being in my new role, I get to see all these different businesses that start to realize, you know what? There's an advantage to them to do something here that they're going to profit from, but also provide an opportunity for families as job opportunities, but also quality of life and recreation opportunities too.
Marilyn Lang, state representative for 6 years. You were mayor for how many years?
1 term, 4 years.
And what are you doing next?
Well, next I'm going to be enjoying a grandbaby coming February 1st. We're having an addition to our family. But thereafter, I'll be running for an open seat for Senate, which still will be representing Fraser, Clinton Township, Mount Clemens, East Point, Warren, Centerline.
So that's a couple years down the road.
That's a couple years down the road.
So in the meantime, you're going to be a grandma?
I'm going to be a grandmom, and I'm going to look forward to doing a lot of good things in the community.
Which you always have, Marilyn.
Thank you. I appreciate
that. Even on a day like today, you're out here supporting the lake, of course.
And the Chamber of Grace. Doesn't she do a great job?
She does.
Always. always promoting. And I just, the Children's Center down here is amazing. And all the things that we really have in Michigan, and here, Macomb and Wayne and Oakland, that sometimes are just our treasures.
Yes.
And it was so good to see Linda.
Linda Walter, she started part-time with us in Clinton Township and built our Parks and Rec program to a fantastic level. Frank Pizzo now runs it the way it should be run. He learned a lot from Linda. It's now his own show. But we try to do that in our areas. And we cooperate with other communities, too. We help them with their Parks and Rec programs. Frazier.
Well, you lead the way. Clinton Township leads the way. Come on, Bob. I said, the other programs that you have and everything that you got going on in Clinton Township, you're a role model. And it wasn't surprising that Linda came from Clinton Township and casting her spell over here and starting to see the things happening here. So it's all credited to you and to the township.
To the whole community. Yeah. We have a great community, a lot of volunteers. And you'd even take a Steve Casson who came from Clinton Township, and we have a lot of police and firefighters who retire and go be chiefs other places because we have such a good staff.
I know. Well, you know what? You lay the foundation. The careers that you set forth in Clinton Township, in the largest township we have in Michigan, is second to none. And, you know, it's so good when we came here. We saw Linda.
Yep.
Kind of felt a little old home week here with her being here and all that she's doing. So.
And we're so glad to be part of SEMCOG because they are regional. They're helping us all in Macomb County, all the other counties that are involved. And they are a big part of what went on here with the riverfront.
Yes, they are. And what would we do without them from a local government? I remember being mayor. They were so instrumental in helping us in local government, and certainly a great voice for us here in Lansing, too, when they bring forth a lot of the issues that are regional. So we couldn't do without SEMCOG.
And a guy that we both support, Mark Hackle, he has embraced the SEMCOG concept from the beginning.
He has. It was nice to see him here today. And a lot of the elected officials that came out, a lot of the board members' businesses that were here, SEMCOG, it was well represented this year.
Well, let's go and have some fun at the party we're going
to
have.
I look
right
forward
now.
To that. Thank you.
We represent a lot of different counties, and I've been very active since I've been supervisor with SEMCOG because of all the benefit you bring to the region and to Clinton Township and Macomb County. But we have a lot of counties, and here you are spending the day in Macomb County on Lake St. Clair. What's the reason for that?
Well, it's obviously, it's a great place to be in the region, and it almost feels like you're at a resort when you're in Macomb County on Lake St. Clair. But of particular note is we're in the process of working on a water resources plan, and what better way to be motivated for that work but to be out on the lake and seeing this great asset for our region.
And we're going to see a couple of additions to our Parks and Rec through the state today.
Yes, we are. In fact, I think we're going to be visiting the DNR Adventure Center, which is a new facility on the Detroit River. We're also going to be looking at the Riverwalk. And these are the kinds of assets that our plan is going to address, because we think it's important to take advantage of these natural assets.
And you've been in charge of a lot of different projects. You want to just mention a couple of them?
Sure. I'm working on the water resources plan right now. And one thing that's new from when we first updated the plan in the 90s is the real interest in water resources and real interest in the blue economy and recreation. So the new plan is going to have a big focus on that. We've also recently completed a traffic safety plan, looking at trying to make sure that the region can be as safe as possible out there on the roads.
Additionally, besides the fact that we're going to have a nice day today, learn some things, you get to rub elbows with Mark Hackle and others that make a lot of decisions for the whole region.
Absolutely. And in fact, we understand that elected officials and local governments, we need them to be engaged in our work for it to be successful. So it's a great opportunity for us to talk to them about what's important to them in Macomb County, but also how that work can be a part of the bigger whole of Southeast Michigan.
And when Mark was campaigning for public office, we brought our group out and explained what SEMCOG was, and he bought right into the whole concept of regional cooperation.
Right. Mark and a number of people from Macomb County government are active participants in SEMCOG. Much of our work is done through committees and task forces, and they're active in contributing to the regional decision making.
Okay, well, we're going to go out and have a good time today. Thank you, ladies, for what you do for Macomb County, Clinton Township, St. Clair Shores, where you are today, and the whole region.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Linda Walter, years ago, you and I started together in Clinton Township. You were a part-time Parks and Rec director, working with a very limited budget.
And we were doing things like tennis tournaments, fun runs, mom Sundays, all kinds of things. And you started Parks and Rec in Clinton Township.
I did. I was given the shot straight out of college by the Parks and Recreation Board. I don't even know if the Township Board was weighing in at that point.
No, they weren't.
It was pretty much the Parks and Recreation Board. And they gave me a shot fresh out of college, part-time, you know, try and do what you can. And it's been the pride of my life to have done what I was able to do for Clinton Township residents.
You built a great department. Now Frank Pizzo has taken your place, and he was really looking up to you the whole time as he learned the ways to do it. And he's doing a fantastic job, by the way.
We learn by just trial and error on what to do. One of my closest friends in life, one of my proudest colleagues that I know, the godfather to my son, there isn't a better human being than Frank Pizzo. And I'm just so incredibly proud of what he's done. It was hard to leave. I actually, for the first year, did not come back once because I had to let them gel and I had to take myself out. And it was so hard because I missed them all so much. But at every step of the way, Frank was incredible. The staff was incredible. And they've done things now that are just great. Frank and I were on a date last week. He took me to about 6 sites and we got to meet a lot of people, catch up with people. And now I feel free to go back because now it's Frank's. And he's done an amazing job, and he's an amazing leader. Township is well served by Frank Pizzo and the entire recreation staff.
We certainly are. But Linda, you have been sought out by the governor to run this beautiful facility. And I know that you were sought out because you told me at the time it was going on. And this is a fantastic place, and I cannot believe the activity and what's here.
I'm very proud of that because we are unexpected, but I will tell you that the invitation would not have been extended had I not had the experience I had in Clinton Township. Two of the very important reasons I was looked at was because I had built a sense of community. I understood community relations, not management, facility management, but people. And the second part was that I had started something from nothing, and that's not easy to understand. So given those two gigantic tasks way back in the day, ended up being very much a direct connection to the opportunity I was extended here.
Now you have expected so many people per day, but you've well exceeded that expectation.
We have over 100,000 guests in our first year of operation. We expected to clock in at about 250 a day, and instead we're over 400. And we haven't even begun most of our programming, so look out because we're just getting started.
Oh, I can't wait for the future, and you've got a great start here, Linda. Congratulations. All of Clinton Township is very proud of you.
Thank you so much.
Grace Short, 9 years you've been doing this on the lake.
Yeah.
And you've been with the chamber for how many years?
37.
That's wonderful.
37 years.
And you've done a great job with the chamber
you.
In Macomb County, and we appreciate it. We appreciate especially you're getting us out of Macomb County now. We're in Detroit, something different than in the past.
Yes. Well, the water is sheer. The water flows
right
in and out of Macomb County and Wayne County. So it is a regional asset, the waterfront. And to get people out on the lake to experience it, those people who make decisions, is very important because they can only make good decisions once they feel the lake, smell the lake, and see the lake.
You've really got a good cross-section of people here today, not only elected officials, but business owners and people that do make a lot of decisions.
Mm-hmm. We have DNR folks and SEMCOG and Land Conservancy folks and legislators. So
I take a lot of pride in the fact that you have taken a regional approach instead of just saying Macomb County and our borders end there.
Yes. Each year we try to do a little bit different. Sometimes we go south, we come to Detroit, we've gone north, St. Clair County. So it is a regional asset. It should be utilized as such and protected as such.
Well, I know Joe Peruzzi and I have been at every single one, and we love coming on these days.
And we love having you, so thank you for being
Thanks,
here.
Thanks, Grace. It's another great day.
Thank you.
Marcotte, you're out here helping the chamber today with your boat, bringing us downriver. What got you involved with the chamber in Macomb County?
Oh, just knowing Steve Remus, he kind of hooked us up and asked us for the use of our boats, and we said no problem, any reason for a boat ride.
So you took a day off, you and your wife, and you're out here catering to everybody, but also you're learning some things too, because we don't know everything, and I'm sure you saw some new things today too.
Yes, definitely. Just what you guys are doing for the quality of the water and everything that we've noticed the past few years, it's just it's really really improved.
And you living on the water, you see the difference every day, don't you?
Yes, sir. Every day.
So the things we've been doing in Clinton Township as well as surrounding areas, we have been cleaning up our sewer problems and the overflow problems, and we're proud to be doing that. But there's still more to be done, a lot more to be done.
I'm not sure what you have planned, but we appreciate anything you guys do. So.
Thank you. Well, thank you for being involved with the chamber today, and thank you for the ride on this beautiful boat.
You're welcome.
You don't call it a boat, though, do you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you do
just
call
a boat.
Okay.
That's all it is.
Thank you. Well, thanks again.
Thanks, guys.
Derek Miller, I knew you before you were a state rep, and now I know you as the person who runs all the money in Macomb County. You're the county treasurer, and you're doing a fine job. I want to let you know that. And the most recent tax issue that you brought to us has run very smoothly, so thank you for doing all that. But we're here for a very special reason today on Lake St. Clair. Right. Now, what is your purpose in being here?
Well, so much of what we talk about is our taxes and how we want to try to keep the property values high. I don't think we focus enough on some of the jewels that we have in Macomb County that really help stimulate the economy and help people want to make Macomb their home and keep Macomb their home. And here we are at Brownies and on Lake St. Clair on such a beautiful day. I'm happy I brought my sunglasses. But we really have to focus on these important things that really make Macomb an incredible, one of the best communities to live in the world, actually. With all the fresh water and things that we have going on here, it's just incredible. So we want to celebrate that, and that's why I'm here, Bob.
And really, the people that you work with now at the top have a focus that the lake is a big asset, and we have to make use of it, and we have to preserve it, which is something that we always haven't done properly.
Absolutely. We need to preserve these resources, and our, you know, environmental is such a huge thing for us. I worked on that when I was in the legislature, and now as county treasurer, we have to continue focusing on that. And, you know, like I said earlier, so much of what we do is try to help communities as a resource collect delinquent taxes. But I was just speaking to the county executive who does such a great job for our county promoting these resources that we have. We must also take note of the incredible things that we have, such as this, and we need to celebrate that, and that's why the Chamber is hosting this event today, and I'm happy that you're here, and we can teach the folks of Clinton Township and all of Macomb County about these resources.
Well, thank you for being here, and thanks for what you're doing at the county level.
Thanks, Bob. Thank you.
We're here at the Milliken State Park in Detroit, 31 acres that's used more than any state park in the state of Michigan. We just had an overview of it, and I'm with one of my special business owners out of Clinton Township, Chuck Riley. Chuck owns two businesses in Clinton Township. He started with his Harley-Davidson dealership on Gratiot Avenue, and then he moved his Parkway car dealership over on Hall Road. And Chuck, you were along for the ride today. You've seen the beauty of the Detroit River. You've seen Lake St. Clair, and you are a man who gets out and does a lot of things in the community.
Well, it is amazing what can happen in a city when you have a fabulous mayor. He is the key to all the investment that happens in this community. And when people have trust in the mayor, they feel very confident in investing in Detroit. And what's been going on here is just way accelerated from whenever I thought it would be.
Exactly, and even around here, you see condominiums being built, you see apartment buildings being built, single family homes up and down the river. It was kind of like a renaissance.
It's been amazing, and people have confidence that the city is safe. They talked about all the security and the cameras that they have, and people monitoring and everything. When people feel safe, it just makes them feel comfortable to come down here.
And last year, Joe Peruzzi and I and the group went over to Belle Isle, and we saw how that is transforming, too, back to its former grandeur, as opposed to being run down like it was for a long time.
Belle Isle is a jewel, and the city of Detroit, from a natural resource standpoint, has everything to offer.
Okay, now let's get back to the Wolverine Harley-Davidson dealership in Clinton Township. Not only do you sell motorcycles there, but you do a lot of charity events every year.
We have probably 8 main charity events that people donate money to go on a ride or to go to an event, various things we do all the time. And we raise a lot of money for the veterans. We're very involved in Veterans Administration. We have a lot of Vietnam veterans that are customers. And our motorcycle chapter, they call it a hog chapter, Harley Owners Group, has many, many Vietnam veterans in it. So we really embrace that part of it.
I've noticed that, of course, and I also noticed that you embrace our public safety defenders, our police and fire departments all the time.
We have given the Macomb County Sheriff's Department motorcycles at a very, very, very reasonable least price, and we always take care of them, get the bikes in and out when they're ready to be serviced and everything else.
Well, you've got two great businesses in Clinton Township. You are one of our stars, and we appreciate it very much, Chuck.
Love Clinton Township.
Good.
An event like this is not possible without our sponsors, and we want to thank McLaren and Macomb, Comcast Business, and the Ballpark in Utica for being sponsors. Without you, an event like this is not possible.
So, you know, it really set home to me that that the water, although it's beautiful, it is also dangerous, which is where McLaren Macomb comes in case there is an emergency, there's a trauma on the water, our proximity, and as the closest trauma center to the lake, you and your loved ones will be coming to our facility and our physicians will be taking care of you.
My kids go to the New Baltimore Rec Center for summer camp every day. Last summer they did not want to go swimming in that water. This summer they've been in that water every day and they're so excited about it. So we're trying to teach the young ones as well the importance of the environment and nature and animals in itself so that we can pass it on down to future generations.
So again, having the chamber do a Lake St. Clair Appreciation Day so we can all appreciate this wonderful, wonderful natural resource that we are all the stewards of. So we all have to work together. We've made a lot of improvements, but we still have a long way to go, as we're all aware of. How all of us work together, because it's not just for us, it's for our children and our grandchildren, generations to follow. It's so important for us to recognize how blessed we are.
We are continuing to working with our business partners, continuing to work with our municipal leaders to try to figure out how do we shore up some of the problems or issues that, I guess if you will, we inherited years ago and try to make it better. Are there things we can do to continuously make this better? You bet there are, and we're going to continue to try to do that. But again, I circle back to my initial conversations and talking about a person like Grace Shore. I can't thank her enough and her staff and the business partners to say, you know what, this is an important asset to Macomb County, an important asset to the region. We all need to participate. We all need to be focused on how do we make sure that the underlying premise of having good water quality is first and foremost, and then let's figure out how do we work on this access so that people even outside of Macomb County are attracted to want to come here.